Welcome to HydroSym Tutorials. This video is an introduction on the HydroSym library. I'll walk you through the interface and show you how to find your way. In a second video, I'll explain the library's basic functions and how to use them in your hydraulic designs. So let's start with the interface. The library is located here, at the right. The local library is your personal and private library folder and is saved on your local or network hard drive. The online library, that's where we are now, gives access to the HydroSym database. Both are categorized by three main elements: components, components plus, and symbols. You'll learn more on these later on. Next, we have the content window and the preview window. If you select a component, this small arrow down here opens the data summary. Here, you'll find more detailed information and some manufacturer specifications. Last, in the middle, or at the bottom if the data summary is closed, you'll find the collapse button, the favorites button, the search bar, and the shortcut to the library page on the Paro website. When working on your designs in the canvas, you can hide and unhide the library by selecting the View Library icon just here. Or use the shortcut alternative by typing Ctrl plus L. This way, you can use the canvas's full capacity while opening the library whenever you need. If you work with multiple screens, instead of hiding the library, you can also drag it to another screen. To do this, right-click your mouse anywhere in the library, select Make Floatable, and drag the library to your second screen. To bring the library back in its standard position, right-click your mouse in the library again and select Align Right. Now let me show you how to find your way. The online library really is an important feature of HydroSym. It holds over 40,000 parts and products from most manufacturers worldwide. And these are all individually specified in components, ready to be included in your designs. If you know the manufacturer's code for a part or product you'll want to use, the search bar will help you find its component in the library. In fact, just the first four characters will mostly do. The search result comes up in the preview window. Now to find its location in the content window, right-click your mouse on a component and select Show File Location in Library. Components are categorized by manufacturer and the product types they make. You can search and select components from here as well. This works the same for symbols, but since they are generic, these are categorized just by product type. To clear the content window when you're done, simply select Collapse All. Adding preferred manufacturers to the favorites list, here in blue, will help you simplify your search. To do this, right-click on a manufacturer and select Add to Favorites. By selecting the Favorites button, the content window will show favorite manufacturers only. Thank you for watching this introduction on our library. If you'd like to learn more library basics, like how to insert elements into the canvas, the difference between components and symbols, and how to create Components Plus, please watch our second library tutorial. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to visit our support area on the Paro website.